the same mistakes that you did. Will not let myself cause my heart so much misery. I will not break the way you did. You fell so hard. I've learned the hard way to never let it get that.
And it's time for our celebrity gossip.
I've got some celebrity birthdays this week.
Have you?
I can't wait for the Moe moment.
So have I.
I'm going to get you to guess the ages.
I've got some celebrity birthdays.
Have you, darling?
I have. Hey. Do you want them?
No, yet.
Okay.
Celebrity talk. Go on, you start us off, Teresa. I know you're desperate to get that one out
there.
A little bit of take that.
Jason, bless him. Jason has gone.
Why?
He's left. He made a statement this week saying how he didn't want to continue with the band anymore, as it simply wasn't what he wanted to do. There's also a statement from remaining members, Gary, Howard and Mark, saying how sad they were, but how they respected his decision and wished him the best. Apparently he hadn't been comfortable doing it in the last couple of years, since I think about 2011, but they are going to be continuing without him. Just continuing as a three.
I do like
him. He became a recluse. So he said he couldn't cope with it all, and he's become a recluse.
He doesn't agree with everybody.
He's made his money, and he's sitting back and enjoying it. Mm-hmm. Go, boy, I say. They all make a recluse.
Sitting back? Well, he's not leaving the house, is he?
Well, he is. He's in a good old armchair.
And sorry, Jason, if you know.
Yeah, no, I mean, I didn't see the last couple of tours have been the first time I've not seen Take That, because I was a big Take That Ian, and I followed them around the Take That Ian. Oh gosh, I used to pretend I was fainting so I could get pulled over the barriers just to get a bit closer to them. I remember going back a few years.
Oh dear.
And then 5 minutes later I'd be there again, and the barriers would be like, thought you fainted.
This is my sister-in-law, and I didn't even know you did that fainting. No. I thought it was for real when you did that.
No. I got that from my mother. She used to do that at Rolling Stones gigs, apparently. So I've heard.
And did she get over that barrier and get hold of one of those Rolling Stones?
I think, as far as I can remember, if I remember rightly, she got thrown off the stage at Wilton Hall.
Oh. Oh, cool.
That's claim to fame, if ever I heard.
Well done, Anne.
I think it was the Rolling Stones or someone playing. They used to have some big names there. Right. Anyway, George Clooney.
Oh, I know.
Oh, he's getting married. Is he married already? I know it's happening sometime this weekend.
It's happening. And you know they're getting married. Oh, in Venice.
In Venice.
Oh, have you been to Venice?
I have been to Venice.
It is one of my favourite places.
Beautiful city.
They've got a 3-day wedding in a gorgeous hotel called the Cipriani.
Oh, my goodness.
And it just sounds amazing. They've got lots of celeb guests there, obviously. And you know, I can imagine all those girls at home screwing up their nose now. But, you know, I'm a big George Clooney fan.
It's very public. They've been just cruising up and down the lakes with the boats and boats of paparazzi following them. Cindy Crawford's there. Matt Damon's there. There's been a fierce bidding war amongst the world's biggest celebrity publications, all desperate to capture the moment.
Are.
But apparently a US edition of Vogue has secured all the rights, and they bidded in excess of $1 million.
Wow.
Well, I mean,
it's paid for your wedding, isn't it?
Well, no, they're going to donate it to charity.
Apparently, so. Yeah. Well, 53 years old he is. And I thought, you know, she's an extremely lucky, beautiful, sexy 36-year-old. Yes, that's 17 years younger than him.
There's hope for me yet, then.
Well, I'm thinking she might get bored and he becomes available again.
Well, he's never said I do before, so it must be a pretty serious thing for him.
Yeah. No, he has been married before.
Oh, has he?
He has. I read that today, years and years ago.
Oh,
and he
right.
said marriage doesn't obviously suit him. He wasn't ever going to do it again.
Yeah. He's not saying that to this wife.
Well, no. The next quote was to say that actually I should have married my second wife first.
Oh.
Well, she's beautiful, isn't she? She is stunning.
She is amazing looking and... Well, they look happy together, don't they? But then shouldn't you be on your wedding day?
Well, you
we're all happy on our wedding day.
We've all been there.
And Catherine Jenkins got married this weekend as well.
Oh.
Hampton Court Palace in London yesterday.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. And Kelly Book, engagement is off.
Oh, I can see that
to David McIntosh.
I'm sorry, Kelly, but come on.
You think the men will be getting excited on that one? Well, Ali, would you get excited? Kelly Brook's back on the market.
Do you know who Kelly Brook is? Do you know? No.
Yes, definitely, did he say?
He said yes, definitely.
He's 18 years old and he likes a bit of Kelly Brook.
Well, she announced it on Twitter.
What, that they were splitting up?
She did. She deleted all photos of him. And she said, it's a sad day, but I wanted to share with you that David and I are no longer engaged on Twitter.
Oh, well, I think it's just very... what do you think, lads? Would you announce it on Twitter?
No, it's private.
It is private. Oh. It is, you're right. But that's not her, basically. That's
what Sam, does she do? Do you like Kelly Brook?
Yeah.
And what would you say Kelly Brook was famous for?
I probably shouldn't say that on radio.
In your words, sir.
Personality. Yes, her personality.
I know.
Her two personalities.
Yeah, exactly. Well, I think she's got a bit Jekyll and Hyde personality, if I'm honest, because she doesn't know what she wants. But give her a due, she certainly pulls them in.
Well, she does. She does. Apparently, though, she did have sort of a bit of a wobbler with this guy because she thought he was more interested in the limelight of being with her.
Well.
But then she gave him a chance and... But
and
you
it
know,
turned out
it
was.
Well, who knows? Who knows? But yes, she wasn't there because he was in Big Brother, wasn't he?
That's right.
And she wasn't there when he entered, and she wasn't there when he exited. So, I didn't watch it, so I don't know what he said about her, if anything at all. But
hey, so moving on, Lionel Richie. Fans of Lionel Richie. Anybody like Lionel Richie?
No, I like some of his music.
Hello.
Well, apparently, this is interesting information. Lionel Richie wants to follow Dolly Parton's footsteps by playing at Glastonbury Legend slot next year.
I'm going to Glastonbury next year.
Are you?
First time. That's one of something we are going to do.
The 5-time Grammy winner.
Grammy.
Grammy. Yes. Well, I was thinking of Dolly Parton there. Yeah. Was apparently a headline act at the Americans' huge festival in Tennessee 3 months ago. So he's now getting a liking for festivals, I'm thinking.
Oh.
Yeah, Lionel, how old is he, do you think, now?
Oh,
Well, he's got to be older than 58, because that's who's
Hello?
On my...
Is it me you're looking for?
Oh, dear.
No.
He sang that to me. I went to
Did
see
he?
Him.
He
I
said it.
Was he?
Was
he?
I'm sure he was looking at me.
Yeah.
Right, and moving on, I've got some celebrity birthdays this week.
Oh.
We're not there. Moe
moment.
We're not doing
that yet. I wanted to tell you he was going to be 58.
Who is?
Theresa May.
Theresa who?
Theresa May.
I was going to say, don't look at me.
Not Theresa
May.
No.
Theresa May be 58.
No.
Oh, no, I need a song. I need to calm down.
Have we got one?
Now she's older
what,
than me.
Song? Who? Theresa May. Not me. No, I am you. Not. That's it. Why? I'm ending this.
Hi. Blessings to each and every one of you. Join me, Darren Hoy, with the Reggae Takeover Show for 2 hours of the finest reggae vibes, each and every Wednesday, 9 through to 11 p.m, here on Seclo Sounds. Don't miss out on your weekly sunshine fix featuring Roots, Rude Boy, Dub, Lovers Rock, Ska, One Drop and much, much more. So go on, give your sound system a treat. Join me, Wind Down Low and Skank the Night Away. One love. That's Wednesdays, 9 through to 11 p.m, live on Seclo Sounds.
It's a top selector.
You're listening to Seclo Sounds, your community radio for Milton Keynes. You can read more about us and our presenters in this month's edition of MK Pulse, our publishing partner.
Written and produced by local people, MK Pulse is a monthly magazine local to Buckinghamshire that enables you to advertise to over 25,000 homes and businesses. That's approximately 75,000 readers. If it isn't delivered to your door, you can visit mkpulse.co.uk.
Another request.
Hello, hi, right. Yes, we have another request, and this one is for Anne of Newport Pagnell, who's asked for this record. I'm not sure if these are the guys that she got through off the stage at Wilson Hall for. She'll have to text us and let us know, but it was definitely someone, Johnny Kidd and the Pirates.
When you move in right up close to me, that's when I get the shakes all over me. Down the backbone, I got the shakes down the knee bone. Yeah, the tremors in the thigh bone, shaking all over.
Yes, we are running slightly behind tonight because we've got all sorts going on in the studio. We should be doing our Moe moment, but we have Ali in the Jungle in the studio. Our Moe moment will be coming up within the next 10 minutes or so. Welcome, guys.
Hello.
Hello.
Now, who do we have here? Ali in the jungle. We have, sitting next to me,